different. One I put behind me. Lord, in your great love,
thank you.
soon be in my standard.
Thank you.
Good morning, and welcome to this 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We also warmly welcome Father Gaspar, who is from the foothills of Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania, and he'll be co-presiding with Father Jimmy. Please silence your phones, stand and welcome one another, and we'll join in our opening hymn. Christ in me, arise and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, arise with your power and your strength. Christ in me, pour out your blessing and healing. Christ in me, arise, and I shall rise with you. Be now my vision, open these eyes. Christ in me, arise and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, arise with your power and your strength. Christ in me, pour out your blessing and healing. Christ in me, arise, and I shall rise with you. Be now my footsteps, leading the way. Christ in me, arise and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, arise with your power and your strength. Christ in me, pour out your blessing and healing. Christ in me, arise, and I will rise with you.
Good morning, everybody. And this Sunday, I'm so happy to introduce to you Father Gaspar Guiara. Father Gaspar Guiara is a missionary from Tanzania. Yeah, he's been a priest for 20 years from the religious order of Society of the Holy Spirit. And you know that this week is our mission appeal Sunday. So he comes today, you know, to share with you his mission work, especially in Tanzania. And you know, we belong in one universal church. And so as one body of Christ, we are here to help those churches who are in need. And so today he's gonna celebrate with us this Mass, and of course, he's gonna preach. And so Father Gaspar Guiara, I'd like to welcome you, and blessings to your ministry. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
With your friends, this Sunday in Ordinary Time, our Gospel reminds us that the Father loves us. Our God loves us. Beyond words. Beyond measure. Beyond our wildest imagination. And to miss that love, or this love, is to miss out the greatest expression of love. My sisters and brothers, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us ask God for his pardon and mercy.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison. You came to call sinners are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore. My Lord, in all the good times, through all the bad times, I say yes, my Lord, to every word you speak.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe the mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. for to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin, death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one, nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but they cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are recounted. So do not be afraid. You are worthy more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ, good morning. Today, I am here to speak on behalf of the Bishop of the Diocese of Rulenge, Ngara, Tanzania, Most Reverend Severine Niwemugizi. My name is Gaspar Kiara, a missionary priest from the Holy Spirit Fathers from Tanzania. First of all, may I express my gratitude to Most Reverend Bishop Mike and also Reverend Pastor Jimmy and you parishioners of the Perpetual Parish for allowing and inviting me to come here to share with you about the missionary cooperation plan for the Diocese of Rulenge, Tanzania. The Diocese of Rulenge is located in the northwestern part of Tanzania. It serves a population of over 1 million people. This includes 334,000 Catholics and 30 parishes. You can see how big such growing population. Many of these people live in an income of under $1 a day and survive only 1 meal a day. Many parts of Africa, people, they don't have breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Just you eat once and that's it. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the Diocese of Rulenge is committed to support these less privileged communities and families through its social services and program. First, training, formation of seminarians, the future priests. Currently, this Rulenge Diocese, as you can see, some of the students and seminarians, the Diocese of Rulenge has 56 senior seminarians who need to be supported with the tuition fee and other expenses. We have also other schools, especially, as I said, there is an ever-growing population, especially young people, orphanage centers, secondary school, young people who have no place for education. And so the diocese is trying to help these young people with education. The only and the best way to prepare the future generations is provide knowledge, to open their minds, their hearts, for the better future. And so, dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the second plan is to provide safe and clean water to the poor communities, which suffer greatly from lack of water. The diocese is planning to drill two wells or to construct three water reservoirs or tanks. And you can see one of the pictures. The bishop was blessing one tank to provide people with the water, because many and hundreds of women and children, especially women and children, they walk miles and miles, 1 to 5 miles, carrying gallons of water in on their head. What I did when I was a kid, carrying gallons like 4 and walk 2 miles taking water at home, this is something. And so the diocese is trying to build this reservoir to provide clean and safe water. The third plan is construction of labor and maternity unit will save hundreds of women and their babies who lack this health care and service. Women usually they carry their babies in long distance to 1 to 3 miles, seeking, looking for hospitals, dispensary, and health care. And so the Bishop of Rulenge is appealing to you for your support, for your prayers to meet these challenges in the diocese. This is what we hear from the gospel today. Jesus challenged our faith that whenever you are the signs of the kingdom of God. You are the signs of hope for the hopeless and the need. And so, by your closeness to the people whom we live, in the families, in the communities, is where we can bring comfort and for those who suffer. Jesus promises we should not fear. We should not be discouraged. And so, Jesus promises that God loves us. As Father said at the beginning of this Holy Mass, that God loves us beyond telling, beyond measurable, beyond price. And so, let us share this love of God in our life. Our closeness to God is through prayers and supportive action of your generosity to the poor. And so, dear sisters and brothers in Christ, the Bishop of Rulenge extends his most profound gratitude for your spiritual and financial support you can provide. Thank you for listening and for your generosity and the sacrificial donations. May God bless you all. Amen.
That the church, its leaders and people, may boldly proclaim the good news of God's kingdom. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
That in the place of sin, of hatred, and the reign of war, the grace of forgiveness and peace of Christ may abound. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
That parishioners weakened through illness of body or spirit feel God's protective hand and our tangible care and concern, especially Manuel Hidalgo. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are fearful or anxious because of the circumstances of their lives may receive encouragement and support from us. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the path we walk be wide enough for all peoples, for the homeless, for refugees in flight, for prisoners, for those with AIDS and HIV, for the ostracized, and for all those whom Christ claims as his own. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord Jesus may acknowledge before his Father in heaven all our beloved dead, especially the 700 migrants who died off the coast of Greece, the victims of war and violence, and the Titanic submersion passengers. Let us pray.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
And in silence, let us bring our personal needs and intentions to God.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, you have entrusted to us the mission of proclaiming your word to a world often unable and unwilling to hear. Hear our prayers and strengthen us with your spirit, that we may never be ashamed of our faith, but confess you as our Lord and Savior, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And following our regular collection, the annual mission appeal to support the Diocese of Werlenge Ngara in Tanzania will be taken. Thank you.
One thing I ask, this alone
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of consolation and prayers, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the Church. And so in company with choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as you celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence in this communion. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the place of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters
the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on your sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. And the peace of the Lord. Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, Father.
I am the good shepherd, and I lay down my life for my sheep, says the Lord.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. Before the power of hell and death is at you.
Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that we may celebrate in constant love and devotion. May be our sure pledge of redemption. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the name of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The Outreach Committee is asking for your support for the monthly food collection. It's been taking place this weekend. If you have forgotten your donation, you can come back after the 11:30 Mass. There will be Outreach Committee members ready to take your donations out of your car, so you don't even have to get out. All ministers are reminded to please submit the availability for July so I can make the schedule. And if you'd like to get involved and become a minister, whether it's an altar server or lector, please let me know. We definitely need more altar servers so that Sonali's not by herself.
Can we give Sonali a big round of applause?
No.
So, you know, if you might pray about it, ask them. That's a great gift. Great gift for God. One thing, you're happy, have a celebration of your own boss here, you know, for a mass, for a family. If you like, you can do it also at the chapel. This is good for you. Okay? And you have a nice reception hall. Beautiful, right? 5-star hotel. The best of the night.
Thank you once again. It is my pleasure that to have this opportunity to pray with you, and the warm welcome I received since yesterday from your pastor. He's a wonderful priest with the open hearts and a warm welcome. Thank you for your prayers and the financial support. As I said, in Africa, we struggle so many things. I am working in a youth center where we are trying to help young people, especially to give them education for their better future. In Tanzania, one secondary school can have more than 1,000 students, boarding school, but still, there are many who have no such opportunity. Thank you for your prayer, and I'm praying for you as we pray for each other. As we said, as faith community, we are united in one God, in one faith, and one love. God bless you all. Thank you, Father.